Hello children, welcome back to my channel. Today let's see question number 6 from NCERT textbook from exercise 14.3. Okay children, this is the NCERT textbook question number 6 where they have asked you to find the frequency polygon. And in this question, you have to find the frequency polygon of section A as well as section B. You need to find the score of the students. So now let's see how to do this.
Mark is nothing but the mid value polygon of the class interval. So now you can see 0 to 10. So what you need to do is you have to add these two and divide it by 2. So that is 0 plus 10 divided by 2, which is equal to 10 by 2, that is equal to 5. The same way when you see 10 plus 20 is 30. So 30 divided by 2 is 15. Since the calculations are very easy, we can write it directly. So this is called as the class mark. So here 0 to 10 class mark is 5. 10 to 20 it is 15. 20 to 30 it is 25, 30 to 40 it is 35, and 40 to 50 is 45. So remember, for frequency polygon, the class mark plays the major role, and this we are going to take along the x-axis and the frequency will be taken along the y-axis. And now is this mid value. Okay, so on x-axis we'll be taking this mid value, and now on y-axis you are going to take 3. So 3 is in between 2 and 4. So you mark it here. So this is 3. And next, the class mark is 15. For 15, you are going to plot 9. Frequency is 9. 9 will come in between 8 and 10. So I'll mark it here. And then next one, the class mark is 15. So in between 20 and 30 we are going to take, that is 15. And here it is 17. Yes. Where will 17 come? 17 will come in between 16 and 18. And then next it is 12. So 12 will come here. Here it is a 12. So we can mark it. And then next it is, class mark is 45. So for 45 you are going to mark in 9. Yes, we will mark 9 here. And you can see already you have an another class. Now you have to join all the points and join the points carefully according to the class mark. And now you can see this polygon is not closed. So you need to see that the polygon should touch on the x-axis. So you have to extend it to the next class mark. Both the before and after, you have to extend the line in such a way that they have to touch the x-axis. Only then the frequency polygon is formed. Now let's see for the section B. As earlier, it is the same. You have to make the class mark. It is 5, 15, 25, 35, 45, and so on. So now for the first one, it is 5. So it is already marked. Then for 15, it is 19. Then next, for 25, it is 15. Then next, for 35, it is 10. Then for 45, it is 1. So now
you have to start with the next step, that is you have to join the points. So join the points according to the class mark. First it is from 5, then it is from 15, then from 15 you have to move on to 25. I am just telling the class mark. You have to join the points on the y-axis according to the class mark. So since it is not touching the x-axis, you have to see that it touches the x-axis by joining the before and the after class mark of the first class interval and the last class intervals. Now you can see this is how you have to construct a frequency polygon when it is two cases. So you can just represent that green lines represent for the section B and the purple line represents for the section A. And now you have to write down what you have taken along the x-axis, that is marks is taken along the x-axis, and what you have taken along the y-axis, that is the number of students is taken along the y-axis. So all this, if it is written only, you will get full 5 marks for this question. Meet you in the next video, children. Until then, take care and bye.